Hello and welcome to another tutorial in monitoring of forest resources. My name is Lutz Fehrmann and in this short video I'm going to talk about three different things. First of all, in one of my last videos I explained how you can create your own survey for mobile data collection in the field using the Open Forest Collect mobile app. Today I like to show you how you can use this application to navigate to some plot locations we have planned in a small inventory area behind the botanical garden. Once we are in the forest, I will briefly talk about slope correction, and my last point will be on border plots, sample plots at the stand boundary that we need to correct. What you see here is an overview map about a small forest patch at the eastern end of the botanical garden. And you can see that we have planned a systematic sample with 20 sample plots in this area. And this is the area where we usually practice some measurements in the field with our students. If you now like to navigate to one of these plots, you can use the Open Forest Collect mobile app to select one of these plots and then use the navigation function that is implemented in this application. Let's, for example, take plot number 10. So if we like to navigate to plot number 10, we need to enter the plot number, we need to enter a team name, and we need to enter the date of our survey. And we can now use a function of this mobile application to navigate to the plot. In this case, you see that the distance to the plot is 480 meters, and we need to go in the direction 84 degrees, which is east. So we need to walk east, and now let's start and have a walk to the botanical garden and try to find plot number 10. So this is the main entrance of the eastern part of the botanical garden at the eastern end of our campus area. And I still have 370 meters to go to the east. So if we enter the garden, we need to go straight uphill. So I still have 160 meters to go. So this is the eastern end of the botanical garden, where we leave the botanical garden, and in the background you see our forest stand that we use for our exercise. There are still 60 meters to go, but here it seems that I need to take a left turn. I have still 20 meters to go. You see, I need to climb up this hill, and it's not for any reason that I'm going to talk about slope corrections in a moment. 8 meters, 7 meters, 6 meters, and here I already see my target, because what you should find at this position is such a wooden stick with the red mark, red color. And this is where we installed these permanent sample plots and where our students are taking measurements every year. So this is a permanent sampling position. So we have reached our plot number 10, and you see we have a slope issue here. Why do we need to talk about slope corrections if we like to assess sample plots? Well, very simply, because all the target variables that we are interested in usually refer to the horizontal map plane. If we talk about volume per hectare, this hectare always refers to the horizontal projection of the terrain and not to the oblique plane or the surface area of our terrain. And that means if we have no option to measure horizontal distances in our plot, but if we measure slope distances, the horizontal projection of this plot will be smaller than our intended plot area. In case of gentle slope and short distances, we can adjust our device manually so that we are measuring horizontal distances. However, if the slope becomes steeper and the distances become longer, this is not possible anymore. And if we use a simple tape, for example, we need to measure slope distances. And now there are two points we need or we can consider for corrections. One option is we can correct our plot radius, if we talk about circular plots, such that the horizontal projection of the plot we are implementing on the slope is equal to our intended plot area. On the other hand, the second option is we install a plot on the slope without any corrections. And in this case, we need to correct our result because, in fact, it refers to a smaller plot area in the horizontal projection. So for the first case, we would install a slightly larger plot on the slope, which is in the horizontal projection exactly as big as we intend our plot to be. If we take a circular plot, we need to enlarge the radius of this plot depending on the slope angle. And the formula for this corrected plot radius is the intended radius divided by the cosine of the slope angle. And that means we would need to measure the average slope angle first to calculate this corrected radius, which will be a little bit bigger than the radius that we would need in a horizontal plane. For the second option I explained, imagine we installed a plot already without any corrections and we know that the horizontal projection is smaller. We need to enlarge our observations, our results from this plot. Imagine, for example, the number of trees per hectare that we derive from this plot here. And this needs to be corrected and it needs to get a little bit bigger. In this case, we would use the observation from our plot on the slope and divide it by the cosine of the slope angle. Okay, so much about slope corrections. The next point I like to address is border plots. And that means sample plots that are very close to the border of our sampling frame or study area, and that will likely overlap the boundary of our forest. And for this purpose, we are looking for an example close to the stand boundary at the lower side of this forest. Let's go there and find a plot at the stand boundary. Okay, I found a spot here which is quite suitable to explain the problem of border plots. You can see here that we have a clear forest boundary and our sampling frame, our forest area that we are interested in, is on this side of the track, while this side of the track is outside of our sampling frame. The problem here is that sampling locations will only be selected inside the forest and not outside the forest. And that also means that the inclusion probability of all these trees at the stand boundary is reduced because they can only be included in a sample if a sample point falls on one side, but not on the other side of their inclusion zone. So somehow we need to correct this. Otherwise, these trees would have a lower probability to become part of the sample than all the other trees in the forest. I have placed a sample plot here just as an example. And the technique that I'm going to explain now is also called the mirage technique. So what we are doing now is we are mirroring the plot at this stand boundary. And this part of the plot, which is overlapping and outside of our study area, we will fold it back into the forest. All the trees that are in this area, in this mirrored area, will be counted twice. So imagine you already assessed the whole plot inside the forest, and now we are going to mirror the plot, and I explain you how this is done in practice. You see our sampling location. In this case, I'm also able to more or less clearly delineate the stand boundary, and I will now measure the distance from this point to the boundary, the shortest distance. which is quite short in this case. It is only 2.5 meters. And I will now mirror this point to a position outside of the sampling frame just by take the double of this distance. So I need a distance of 5 meters now. And I find it here. So I would now install a temporary sampling location at this position, which is exactly mirrored. And I will implement the same plot design again and check which of these border trees would be included in the sample if I implement the sampling location here. And all these trees will be counted twice, and there are two different ways how to do that. You can just copy and paste the entries in your data sheet because you already recorded these trees, or you just use a factor or a variable accounting factor that tells you these trees need to be counted twice, a kind of correction factor. So this is how we mirror a plot in practice. So you have now learned everything that you need to assess the sample plots here in our study area. You have learned something about slope correction, you know how to correct border plots, and you already learned how to take measurements on single trees in the earlier videos. If you go out to train plot assessments and measurements on single trees, you also find the survey guidelines for this survey in the mobile application that you installed on your smartphone. And here you can follow all the single steps that you need to do to collect the data. If you collect data, it would be nice if you export the data and if you provide it to all other students or send it back to me, then we can use these examples for data analysis later on. In the following videos, we will talk about data analysis using some older data from this area. And thank you for watching so far. See you back in one of the next tutorials.